Hey guys, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Today's topic is about creatine and hair loss. Does it cause it? Does it not? I'll give you a real life scientific as well as empirical truth about it. Now, I remember the first time I found out about creatine. You know, it was super expensive. It was like 4 ounces was like $100 or $120. And you know what? I had to have it, right? It was the early 90s. I didn't have much money and I gave it a try. And well, it never really worked out the way it claimed it would, at least not for me. However, there are numerous studies linking creatine to increased strength, muscle, and athletic performance, as well as just improved recovery post-workout. And the good news is that creatine is one of the most studied sports supplements in history and has a fairly safe track record. If you use it correctly at the correct dose and the right type or form of creatine, which I'll tell you about in a minute. However, today's topic is about creatine and hair loss, which is what a few of my viewers have asked about repeatedly. Is there any proof, either scientifically with clinical studies or empirically with real-life feedback? Now, there's only one study in 2009 connecting creatine to hair loss, and it wasn't really a correct connection. It basically consisted of 20 rugby players who took about 25 grams of creatine daily for 3 weeks. Now, the researchers found that creatine may increase the conversion of testosterone to dihydrotestosterone, and DHT is believed to be one of the hormones behind male pattern baldness in men genetically predisposed to hair loss. And I'll give you the link to another very important video about the real cause of hair loss at the end of this one, because DHT is not the primary hormone. It's a misconception. However, the study did not prove that creatine can actually cause hair loss. Not only did the researchers not even mention the hair loss, but it was extremely small study with only 20 people and for a very limited time, you know, about only about 3 weeks. Lastly, the increase in DHT was not very large and it was still within the normal ranges. So the bottom line is that no, taking creatine will not cause hair loss. Genetics aside, hair loss is a hormonal and an inflammatory cause. Let's talk about anecdotal evidence. If you do searches online about this topic, creatine and hair loss, you will see a few guys, you know, saying that they did notice hair loss when they started taking creatine. However, this is, again, all anecdotal, and it's what someone thinks or feels. It's not scientific in any way, shape, or form. And these same guys have also stated that when they stopped taking the creatine, the hair loss stopped and the hair grew back. So there's a positive right there. The bottom line here is, listen, if you are concerned about hair loss, then my suggestion is you don't do anything that could potentially turn on or accelerate the process, and thus just do not take creatine. Or if you do, take a very low dose, about only 3, maybe 5 grams daily. No loading, and make sure you cycle it. Then see how you respond and feel. If you get hair loss, then stop. And with that said, I do have an entire series of hair loss videos, causes and solutions. You can watch the first one, which is how baldness and hormones are connected. Just scroll down below this video to the description area, click the link and start watching. And I also have a video specifically about creatine, if it's safe and how to use it correctly. As always, thanks for watching and have a happy and healthy day.